Yes. Good evening all. So the news is that we have discussed about the revised syllabus for 2020-21 academic year. Okay. So as per that, in this arithmetic progressions, they have removed the last section where application-based questions from arithmetic progressions will not be asked in your 2021 academic year board exams. Okay. So board said that it is a one-time affair. That means your juniors for next year, they might be having or they might roll back to the same syllabus. So if time permits during the academic year, once we finish everything as per the new syllabus, if time permits, we will do the remaining parts also, so that having extra knowledge is of no worry. So it is useful for you only. Okay. So in earlier classes, we did exercise 5.1, few problems from exercise 5.2 had given an assignment also. So in this session, we will continue with that. Okay. So before continuing with exercise 5.2, I will actually do the derivation. Okay. Do the derivation for sum of n terms. This is the last concept from your chapter. Okay. So this is the last concept from your chapter. So very important, students. So first is we will do the last concept that is remaining, the concept, conceptual subject that you have to study from this chapter. That is sum of n terms. Okay. Sum of n terms in an AP. Okay. That means if I give you 10 terms of that AP and ask you what is the answer for the summation of all the terms in the AP, if I give you 50 terms, okay, without actually performing the addition, you should be able to give me the answer. So for example, if I ask you this, so the AP is this, S is equal to 2, 5, 8, 11, so on. Okay. So I say, what is the sum of 100 terms? That means what should you do? You should say sum is equal to S100, because sum of 100 terms is equal to 2 plus 5 plus 8 plus 11 plus, so on till how many terms? 100 terms. So how do you find out the 100th term? That means A100 is equal to A plus 100 minus 1 into D. So here A is 2 plus 100 minus 1 is 99 into D is the difference. 5 minus 2 is 3. So that is nothing but 2 plus 297. That gives me 299. So that means I have to say 2 plus 5 plus 8 plus 11, so until 299. So if I have to perform this, what is the answer and how do you find out? That is this. So you cannot keep on doing manual calculation, correct? That is 2 plus 5, 7, 7 plus 8, 15, 15 plus 11, 26, plus so on. So you can't keep on doing this. So you need to have a formula. So we derive that formula and we learn. See how we studied about the general term. We studied the general form of AP. That means we said AN is equal to A plus N minus 1 into D. You studied this formula, right? So similarly, I want a formula for SN. So what do you mean by SN? Sum of N terms of an AP. So how do you find out that? Okay, is that clear? Did you get the preface of this derivation? What this derivation talks about? Yes? Any doubts, students? Is that clear? So here basically, so what is the question or the heading? What is the title for us now? That is sum of n terms of an AP or in an AP. That means how many of our terms I give you in that AP, you have to add those terms and you should give me the answer. For example, so I'll give you a very simple example. So I give you this. Okay. So what kind of an AP is this? This is a finite AP. Why is it finite AP? Because my AP is terminating at 5. So what is A in this case? A is 1. What is L? The last term is 5. What is D? D is nothing but I can easily find out using first two terms as 2 minus 1 is equal to 1. Correct? So these are all informations what I am trying to give you. So if I ask you what is sum of these terms, sum of how many terms, there are how many terms? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So I can say sum of 5 terms is equal to 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4 plus 5. That is equal to 1 plus 2 is 3, 3 plus 3, 6, 6 plus 4, 10, 10 plus 5, 15. So this is sum of n terms of this AP. Okay. Similarly, if I give you AP like this, 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12. Again, a finite AP, correct? So what is A for this? Let me know. You guys answer me now. What is A for this? What is A? Yes, A is equal to 2. What is L? What is L? Yes, L is 12, correct. The last term, L is last term. What is D? What is D? Yes, D is 2. So how do I get? I can take 2 adjacent numbers. So I'll take 6 minus 4 is equal to 2. Yes, D is 2. Now tell me, what is S? How many terms I have? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So yes, 6. So what is the answer for that? I should do 2 plus 4 plus 6 plus 8 plus 10 plus 12. What is the answer to this? What is the answer to this? Is it 32? Dhanush says 42. Huh? Yes, it is 42. Okay. Yes, 6 is 42. Yes. So I hope now you have understood the pretext. Did all of you catch the pretext now? So what we are trying to derive here. So here we did the manual calculation for addition. That means here I had given you 5 terms. Here I had given you 6 terms. So it was very quite easy for you. You did manual calculation. You did oral calculation. So what if I give you an example like this? You observe now. So my new example is 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, so on till 200. So if I ask you, S is equal to how much? So manual calculation is not, I'm not saying it is not possible. It is possible, but it is time consuming. So we have to try and find out, can I find out a relationship where I can find the same answer using a formula instead of going for manual calculation? So that is the aim. Okay, that is the aim of this section, that is sum of n terms of AP. So sum of n terms of AP. So the heading is sum of n terms of AP. So I'll show you the derivation. So derivation of the formula, derivation of the formula. Okay. How do we do the derivation? So observe very carefully. So before going into derivation using variables, I will give you an example. Okay, I'll give you an example and try to explain with respect to numbers. Okay, so let us say S is equal to 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4 plus 5. Okay, I want to do this. 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4 plus 5. Okay, so I will consider this as my equation number 1. Okay. Is that clear? This is very simple. This is given. There is nothing very big in this. Next, what I will do is I will reverse the order. What do you mean by reverse the order? Same, yes, I will write it as 5 plus 4 plus 3 plus 2 plus 1. Will it change? Will the answer change if I do this? If I do 1 plus 2 plus 3 or 3 plus 2 plus 1, will it change? No. Correct? So I will get the same answer. So I will take this as equation 2. Okay, once I have done this, observe students, what I will do is equation 1 plus equation 2, this I will do. So if I do on LHS, what do I get? S plus S. Is this clear? On LHS, I'll get S plus S. Correct? Is that clear? On RHS, what do I get? Now students, I will start clubbing the terms. What do you mean by clubbing the terms? See, this plus this I will do, correct? So and then this plus this, then this plus this, then this plus this, then this plus this. Correct? Because I have to add this. So what I'll do, 1 plus 5 plus 2 plus 4 plus 3 plus 3 plus 4 plus 2 plus 5 plus 1. So we observe one beautiful thing that here, all are giving me answers as 6. Correct? How many times did you get 6? Tell me this. How many times do you get 6? Observe how many times. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So 5 into 6. Or rather, I'll write it as. What is the answer? First, I will write that. So I got answer repeated 5 times. Correct? Let's just, what do I get? 2s. Therefore, s is equal to 6 into 5 divided by 2. 2 ones are 2, 3s are 15. So if you observe, when we did 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4 plus 5 earlier also, we had got answer as 15. Using the method here also, we got answer as 15. But we have not derived the formula yet. Correct? We have not derived the formula yet. That is what. So I think you might have got a brief idea how to do the derivation now, correct? So what did I do? My first step is I write the sum of n terms, then I do the reverse order, then I add both. This is what I'll do. Once adding, I start doing the clubbing like this. Correct? Yes. So I will give you one more example. So let's take same. S is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, so on till 100. I'll do this, okay? So my S series starts from 1, ends at 100. So, okay, so this is my AP. Okay, this is my AP. So now I will write the sum of n terms. That means S. How many terms are there? 100 are there. So there are 100 terms. So I have to find out what is S100. So let S is equal to 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4 plus 5 plus so on till 100. So this is my equation 1. Then what should I do? I should reverse the order. Reverse. So when I reverse, still the answer will remain the same. So LHS will be S only. But I am just doing 100 plus 99 plus 98 plus 97 plus 96 plus so on till 1. Is that clear? Once I have done this, I have to add both equations, 1 plus 2. Once I do this, what will be my LHS? S plus S. S plus S. Then RHS, 1 plus 100. I'll start clubbing like this. Then 2 plus 99 plus so on till 100 plus 1. So here each answer I get it as 101. But how many times do I get this? How many times do I get this? I have to see. That is the reason I wrote it here. How many times do I get it? 100 times. Correct? So I get it 100 times. So I can say 101 into 100, LHS will be my 2S. Therefore, S is equal to 100 into 101 divided by 2. So I can say 100 into 101 divided by 2. So 2 ones are, 2 50s are. Therefore, S100 is equal to 5050. So students, did you understand this? I have given you two examples now. Okay, so we have done this derivation. Basically, this is not called as derivation. We are trying to understand the derivation with the help of numbers. So as I told you in earlier classes, derivation is nothing but it involves variables and should be applicable for all the conditions that we define. Okay, for all the conditions, whatever we define, it should be applicable. So let us move on to that. Okay, let us move on to that and let's try to find out. Now comes the general form. Okay, general form. So I'll say general form for sum of n terms of an AP. Sum of n terms of an AP. Okay, so if I have to write it in general form, I should be able to define my AP. Okay, I should be able to define my arithmetic progression in general form. That means how? So my term starts with A. What will be my second term? Yes, students, can you tell me what will be my second term? If A is my first term, what should be my second term in general format? What should be my second term? Second general format. Yes. Is it? Yes. Correct. So if this is my first term, yes, next will be, I should add D to my first term. That means A plus D. So if A is my first term, my second term is A plus D. So what will be my third term? A plus 2D. Then it will become A plus 3D. So on. So what is my nth term? What is my nth term? What should be my nth term? A plus n minus 1 into d. This is the general form of nth term, not a plus n d. A plus n minus 1 into d. See guys, I am trying to just ask questions in different form. That's all. You have already studied all this. You must not make any mistakes with this. It is a plus n minus 1 into d, the last term. If a is the first term, I told you, then l is the last term. So l, this is l. A plus n minus 1 into d. That is, this is nothing but what? This is the general form of nth term of AP. General form of nth term. This we have studied. Am I right? Yes. So now students, we have to find out what is Sn. This is our aim. What is Sn? A plus d plus a plus 2d plus so on till a plus n minus 1 into d. Is this correct? This is my equation 1. Is this correct? Is this correct? Anybody having any doubts with this? Yes. So what should be my next? What should be my next step? What should be my next step based on the examples that we studied? Yes, I should reverse it. I should write it in reverse order. That means I should write the last term first. That means a plus n minus 1 into d. So what will be last but one? A plus n minus 2 into d. Correct? That means the term before this. Plus so on. Till what will be the last term after reversing? It will be a. Any doubts here? Anybody, any doubts? Understood? I have written it in reverse order. So then we have to club these two. Anybody having doubts how I wrote this? Anybody having any doubts as to how this came? See, a plus n minus 1 into d is the general form for nth term. Okay. See, students, those who are having doubts, I will tell. An is given as a plus n minus 1 into d. This is nth term. Correct? We call it as nth term. What is n minus 1th term? Can anybody tell me this? This is nothing but a plus. See, in place of n, what should I put? N minus 1. So n minus 1. In place of n, wherever n is there, I have to put n minus 1. So I'll get it as a plus n minus 2 into d. Yes. This is what? A n minus 1. Next, what will be? N minus 2th term. So what will it become? A plus n minus 3d. Whole AP will not have n minus 1 form. Okay, I'll erase this part. This is extra thing that I wrote. Yes, Now you continue like this. What will be next? A minus n, a plus n minus 4d, a plus n minus 5d, a plus n minus 6d. So when you go for first term, it will be a plus n minus nd. A plus n minus nd. N minus n becomes 0, so only a will remain. So if you want to understand this, you guys have to manually write this. You should write this manually completely. Next will be a plus n minus 3d, a plus n minus 4d. Yes, you have to try that Siddhant. Next you continue like that. It will become a plus, see, this will become a plus n minus nd. When you write in the reverse order, this will get cancelled. It will become zero. So only a will remain. If you follow this fashion, okay, a plus n minus 1 into d, a plus n minus 2 into d. Next becomes a plus n minus 3d, a plus n minus 4d, a plus n minus 5d. So like that till how many terms? A plus n minus nd. Because this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, like that till n. Is that clear? Anybody having any doubts? Yes? So this is my equation 2. So what should I do next? I should do 1 plus 2. Correct? So what will happen to my LHS? Sn plus Sn. My RHS, this I will take a plus, then I will write this a plus n minus 1 into d. So I have clapped those two, then comes plus sign, plus next I have a plus d, correct? So a plus d plus a plus n minus 2d plus so on till this I will write a plus n minus 1 into d plus a. Anybody having any doubts? So now if I observe, a plus a gives me answer as 2a plus this is n minus 1 into d plus a plus d plus a plus n minus 2d. So if I open the brackets, I'll get it as a plus d plus a plus n minus 2d. Correct? So a plus a, we have to observe this. Plus, so on till plus. A plus a is how much? 2a plus n minus 1 into d. I will explain once again. Okay, so if you observe here, this becomes 2a plus n minus 1 into d as it is, I'm not changing, plus a plus a is 2a plus n will keep as it is, minus, since minus 2d is here, plus d is here, it will become n minus 1 into d plus so on till 2a plus n minus 1 into d. So what is our observation here? What is our observation? Our observation is 2a plus n minus 1 into d is repeating. So LHS, what do I get here? 2 times Sn. Here also I'll get 2 times Sn. Now can you tell me how many times 2a plus n minus 1 into d is repeating? That means this factor, how many times does it repeat? Yes, in all terms, how many times? How is it 3 times? How is it 3 times? Yes, n times, because how many terms are there in this series? How many terms are there in this AP? There are n terms in this AP. See, observe, n terms. There are n terms in this AP. So it will repeat n times. So if it repeats n times, what should I do? So what will become my LHS? LHS will remain as it is, 2Sn is equal to 2a plus n minus 1 into d. This has repeated how many times? N times. 2a plus n minus 1 into d has repeated n times. Therefore, what will be my Sn is equal to n into 2a plus n minus 1 into d whole divided by 2. So I can say my formula for Sn is n by 2 into 2a plus n minus 1 into d. This is the formula that you should remember. This is the formula for sum of n terms of AP. Okay, here there is a variation. What do you mean by variation? I can rewrite it. How can I rewrite it? Observe, this is very important. N by 2. What I will do is 2a can be written as a plus a. Is that correct? 2a can be written as a plus a. So I will write it like this, a plus a, and this I will keep as it is, plus n minus 1 into d. Now tell me, what is this? What is a plus n minus 1 into d? What is a plus n minus 1 into d? Yes, this is an. That means I can say last term. What is this? This is my first term. So I can say, therefore, Sn is equal to n by 2 into a plus l. This is also, we call it as variation, one of the other forms. Yes, nth term I have represented it as l. Nth term is nothing but the last term, so l. So what I can say in general I can say Sn is equal to n by 2 into first term plus last term. Okay, first term plus last term. So how do we observe? Let's go back to the example. So let us take this. So now you will apply that. That is, Sn is equal to n by 2 first term plus last term. That's what I said. So how many terms are there? There are 100 terms in this. Into first term is what? 1. What is the last term? 100 divided by 2. That is nothing but 100 into 101 divided by 2. Correct? 1 plus 100 is 101. So that's what I got in this step. 100 into 101 divided by 2. So this also you must remember, students. Okay, this variation you should know. Fine, I will explain once again. I'll explain from the beginning. Please listen very carefully. I'll explain from the beginning everything, okay? So this is the general form of AP. The general form of AP is given as a comma a plus d comma a plus 2d comma a plus 3d, so on till a plus n minus 1 into d. So this is my first term, this is my second term, this is my third term, so on, and this is my last term. The last term is denoted as L. So last term is nothing but nth term. Okay, so now I have to find out the sum of n terms. So sum of n terms means I have to just put plus sign here. I have to add everything. So a plus d plus a plus 2d plus so until a plus n minus 1 into d. So that I have denoted as Sn. Next, what I have to do is I have to write it in the reverse order. Reverse order. So that means last term becomes the first term. So instead of saying 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, I'm saying 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. So last term becomes the first term when I do it in reverse order. So last but second term becomes the second term in reverse order. Last but third term becomes the third term in the reverse order. So first term becomes the last term in reverse order. Okay? Fine. So once I do this, I have to add both. Okay, I have to add both. So I have to do 1 plus 2, first equation plus second equation. So here I have to start clubbing. So how do I club here? So how do I club here? So what did I do for clubbing? So first term of this plus first term of this. Second term of this plus second term of this. Similarly, last term of this plus last term of this. Is that clear? Any doubts still here now? I hope this is clear now. Correct? That same thing I have written. So what have I written here? I have written a, then a plus n minus 1 into d, a plus n minus 1 into d. So I have added these two. Correct? Next, a plus d as it is, a plus n minus 2 into d, a plus n minus 2 into d. Okay, plus so on like that. The last term is a plus n minus 1 into d. I have written a plus n minus 1 into d and plus a. So I have written plus a. Is clubbing clear now? Is the clubbing part clear? Yes? Is it clear to everyone? So listen very carefully. Listen very carefully. First part here, I have written as it is, the first term. The first term here, I have written here. I have added. Is this clear? Is this clear? A plus n minus 1 into d. A plus n minus 1 into d. A plus d, a plus d. A plus n minus 2d, a plus n minus 2d. So until a plus n minus 1 into d, a plus n minus 1 into d plus a, plus a. Yes, is that clear now? Okay, once I have done this, it's all with respect to now, just arithmetic. A plus a gives me 2a, remaining part I have kept as it is, n minus 1 into d. Okay, a plus a is 2a, n minus 2d, n minus 2d is nothing but n d minus 2d, and I have kept 1 plus d here, so it becomes n d minus d. If I take d common, it become n minus 1 again. So that is what is here. So what we observe here is basically 2a plus n minus 1 into d is repeated. That is this part. 2a plus n minus 1 into d is repeated. How many times is it repeated? N times, because there are n terms in the AP. So I can say that's what 2 plus 2 plus 2 is nothing but 2 is repeated how many times? 3 times. So addition becomes multiplication. I should see how many times it is repeated. So 2a plus n minus 1 into d is repeated n times. So I have to multiply n here. LHS is 2 into Sn. So therefore Sn is equal to n into 2a plus n minus 1 into d whole divided by 2. I have just rearranged it like this. That is n by 2, 2a plus n minus 1 into d. So this is the general form. This is very important formula. Okay, this is very important, which you must know. Further to this, first term 2a can be split as a plus a, because this is what we know. A plus a. So after splitting, I will club like this. A plus n minus 1 into d. That means one part of a here and n minus 1 into d are clubbed. So we know a formula for this. A plus n minus 1 into d is nothing but the last term of AP. That is nth term. Nth term formula we studied. An is equal to a plus n minus 1 into d. I had told you that an is also nothing but the last term L. So this is the alternative formula. That means I can say a plus l, n into a plus l divided by 2. This I have written in word format. That means n by 2, first term plus last term. Is that clear? Yes? Is that clear to everybody? Yes? See students, why? See, they might not ask you this derivation, okay? Derivation will not be asked, okay? Derivation will not be, but why am I stressing on this and why am I spending almost 30 to 40 minutes on this? Because the way, better way you understand the logic of derivation, the derivation purpose is, you should be, if you know the derivation, you can solve any type of question, okay? You can solve any type of question. Because you will know the method how that formula came into picture. If somebody says Pythagoras theorem, if you know how Pythagoras theorem came into picture, you will never forget it. Similarly, this also. That is the reason I gave you examples in the beginning. This is the logic. That means we wrote it in forward order, then we reversed it, then added. Okay, here also you observe students. What is the first term? First term is 1. What is my last term? Last term is 5. How many terms are there? 5 terms whole divided by 2. That is 5 into 6 divided by 2. That is 15. Okay. Fine. Is that clear? Is the derivation very clear to all of you? Yes. So this is the last concept of this chapter. Okay. Actually, this is the last concept, and as per your new syllabus, it ends here itself. That means they won't ask you any application based questions from this. I have to just motivate you for this part. Okay. I have to just motivate you for this part. Derivation will not be asked, but I suggest, my strong recommendation, further, with further your educational career in mind or any other point of view, knowing the derivation and having this knowledge is very much necessary. It will not harm you at all. It might consume half an hour or 1 hour of your extra time, but knowing this will definitely help you out, especially with arithmetic section. Okay, fine. Yes. So this is the last concept of this chapter. So let me just summarize to you what and all we studied. So we studied, the first concept was, what is AP? That is its definition. We studied AP. Then we studied the types, that is finite and infinite. We said what is finite, then we said what is infinite. Then we talked something about terms of the AP. Okay. Then also we spoke about general form of AP. General form of AP. Okay. This is very important. General form of AP. Then we studied general form of nth term of AP. This is nothing but an is equal to a plus n minus 1 into d, or the formula. Then we studied the general formula or general form of sum of n terms of AP. Sum of n terms of AP. That's what we studied just now. That is Sn is equal to n by 2, 2a plus n minus 1 into d. These are the concepts involved in this chapter. Okay. Terms under this, we studied the first term. Then also we studied about the last term. And also the general definition of, or general meaning of, the word term. Okay. Is that clear? These are the concepts involved in this. Okay. Earlier also it was the same. Now also it is the same. So they have not removed any concepts from this chapter. Okay. But only thing is, they have removed the application based questions from this chapter, so which will not be asked. Okay. And the last thing, the Siddhant, whatever you have written, that is not the general form of AP. Say, general form of AP is only this. A comma should come, not plus. Comma should come, not plus. Okay. You should not put plus in between. If you have not put plus, then it is correct. A plus n minus 1 into d. So this is the general form of AP. Good. Fine. Is that clear to all of you? Any doubts in this part? Yes? No doubts? No doubts. Good. So if that is the case, let us continue with mathematics arithmetic progression, our numerical problems. Okay. So we were doing some numerical problems in earlier class. We had done till 8 question. Also, I had given some homeworks to you. That is assignment question. So let's continue with this. Okay, fine. So the question reads like this. Is from exercise 5.2. Okay, this is the second exercise itself. So that is, second exercise mostly deals with the general form of AP, of that is n terms, and some, it doesn't involve a sum of n terms. So I have now done with, I am done with the concepts of the chapter arithmetic progressions. Now let us go back and look for exercise 5.2. We shall continue from there. So we had left here to question number 8. So let's go to question number 9. So question number 9 reads like this. If the third and ninth terms of an AP, so that is third and ninth terms of an AP are 4 and minus 8 respectively, which term of the AP is 0? So AN is equal to 0. So basically they are asking which term. So I have to find out the term, that means N. So I have to find out N. Which term of the AP? Which term of the AP means I should find out the position of the term in the AP. So third term they have given it as 4 and ninth term they have given it as minus 8. So they have asked you which term is 0. Okay, so here I don't know what is the first term, I don't know what is the second term, what is the third term? Third term is given as 4. I don't know what is fourth term. Fifth is not known, sixth is not known, seventh is not known, eighth is not known, ninth is given as minus 8, and so on. Okay, so observe students, 4 is present here, minus 8 is here, so 0 should come somewhere here, correct, in between this. So that means my answer, I can guess, will be somewhere between third and ninth. Am I correct with this? Am I correct? So I cannot have 0 after this, I cannot have 0 before this. Why? Because it is a reducing AP. I can see minus 8, it has gone into minus. So how do I find out this? What is the formula that I can use? So we had used this, correct? A plus n minus 1 into d is equal to 4, and a plus n minus 1 into d is equal to minus 8. For this, what is n is equal to 3? For this, what is n is equal to 9? So if I do the substitution, what will I get? A plus 4 minus 1 into d is equal to 4. For this, I'll get a plus 9 minus 1 into d is equal to 9, which means a plus 5d is equal to 4, which means a plus 8d is equal to 9. So this is my first equation, this is my second equation. What can I do? I will just do the subtraction. What do you mean by subtraction? I'll do 1 minus 2. If I do this, what will I get? A plus 5d, I will write as it is. Since I'm doing minus a plus 8d is equal to RHS 4 minus 9. That means a plus 5d minus a minus 8d is equal to minus 5. So that means a minus a, so a cancels, 5d minus 8d is minus 3d is equal to minus 5. Correct? Any doubts here? Any doubts? So this is 3 minus 1. So this becomes 2D. Correct. Whatever you have noted down is correct. So this should be a plus 2d. So this also will become 2d. So minus 6d. Any mistakes, students? You must make out the mistake. You should only tell me what is the mistake. Tell me the mistake. Tell me the mistake. What is the answer? See, during exam, if you make small mistake, it will take so much of time for you to rectify. Yes, correct. Correct. So, A plus 2D minus A minus 8D is equal to minus into minus becomes plus. So, AA cancels. I'll have minus 6D is equal to 12. So, D is equal to minus 2. What is D is equal to? Minus 2. Yes, D is equal to minus 2. So now they've asked AN is equal to 0. So 0 is equal to, yes. Yes, who will answer me now? They've asked for AN is equal to 0. 0 is fifth term. Yes, correct. Fifth term is correct. So here, students, there are two ways of answering this. See, now here it is 4. So what will be next term after 4? 4 minus 2, correct? So 4 minus 2 is 2. Next term, what will it be? 2 minus 2. So this becomes 0. So therefore, this portion is the answer. Where does this portion lie? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So fifth is the answer. But you should not do like this in exam. So in exam, how you should do is, once you have found out D, you should find out A. How do you find out A? Put the value of D here. What will I get? A plus 2 into minus 2 is equal to 4. That means A minus 4 is equal to 4. A is equal to 8. That's what you should not count and give the answer. So A is equal to 8. You got D is equal to minus 2. So then what should you do? Once you have got this, what should you do? Yes, once you have got this, what should you do? Now you know what is value of A. You know value of A as 8, D as minus 2. So AN is equal to 0. That means 0 is equal to A plus N minus 1 into D. So 0 is equal to 8 plus N minus 1 into minus 2. So if you simplify this, you'll get N as 5. Is that clear? Yes? Shall we move on then? Yes. I'll give you 10 seconds of time. Can you solve this? So the question reads like this. The 17th term of an AP exceeds its 10th term by 7. Find the common difference. Try solving by yourself. The 17th term of an AP exceeds its 10th term by 7. Find the common difference. Yes, I will be uploading this video in the app. Yes, how is it one? I need explanation, not just the answer. You could have given me by looking at the back end of your textbook also. Huh? No counting. You must not do counting. If I give you what is the 200th term exceeds the 500th term by 7, how will you do? Yes, Shreya has given one. Okay, fine. But how will you solve that? How will you simplify? See, they have given, see, A 17th term exceeds A10 by 7. Is that correct? That means how? A17 minus A10 is equal to 7. No, you should not do 17 minus 7. If you do this, it is wrong. Then all my teaching has gone waste. 17 minus 10 cannot be done. 17 and 10 are subscripts. I have told you cannot subtract the positions. Shreya has written it correctly. Yes, A17 minus A10 is equal to 7. Correct. But further, how do you proceed? How do you proceed? Further, how do you proceed? Correct, correct, good, good, it's correct. See, now I have to write, what is A17? A17 is A plus 17 minus 1 into D. What is A10? A plus 10 minus 1 into D. So I have to do the substitution now. That means in place of A17, I will put A plus 16D. Then minus is there, minus A plus 10 minus 1, 90. So I'll put the brackets is equal to 7. So if I open the brackets, A plus 16D minus A minus 90 is equal to 7. A cancels. 16 minus 9 is 7. So 7D is equal to 7. Therefore, D is equal to 1. If, see, so remember students, from Siddhant example, I am telling you, see, he has raised a good. His mistake is lesson for everybody. You cannot do subtraction. You cannot do 17 minus 10. This is not allowed. Is the solution clear to all of you? Is it clear to all of you? Anybody, any doubts? You cannot do that, Siddhant. Then your explanation is wrong. You cannot give that explanation. That is not correct. Technically, it is not correct. You cannot say 17 minus 10 is equal to 7. So I have to do 7 division. That is not correct. Technically not possible. Okay, fine. Is that clear to all of you? See, this question is same as the previous one. Okay, so this is your assignment question. This is your assignment question. Which term of the AP 3, 15, 7, 27, 39, so on, will be 132 more than its 54th term? So this is your assignment question. Shashank, you note down this. I will be uploading this video today itself. You can just make a note of it, okay? Because almost it is time now, so I have to close it. So please note down, this is your assignment question. 3, 15, 27, 39 will be 132 more than its 54th term. This is exactly same as 10th question, that is previous question. This assignment should be submitted by tomorrow. Okay, noted. Let's go to next one. So the question reads like this. Two APs have same common difference. The difference between their 100th term is 100. What is the difference between their 1000th terms? Okay, so this is also your assignment question. This is similar to previous one, but little involves little bit of thought process. So this is also your assignment question. So question 11 and question 12, both are your assignment questions. Fine. Okay. So I'll conclude the class here. I hope you all enjoyed this class. This is good. So this week I will be, if possible, I'll do a session on trigonometry. Then I'll give you one more test on trigonometry. Okay, fine. So I'll close the session now. Okay, thank you, students. Attend the next one, science class.